In this video, I'm going to show you how to create this design right here in Kittl, and I'm going to use one of the new features that they just released, and that is the gradient feature, which you can use on text as well as objects and shapes. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. It's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a design in Kittl using their new feature, the gradient feature. I'm going to put it on some text, I'm going to put it on an object, and we're just going to make a fun design that you can use. And I'm going to show you where you can find more of these, like these chrome effects and some other effects on Kittl, so that you can use them if you don't know how to make them on your own. So let's get into Kittl right now, and I'll show you how to do it. All right, so here we are on Kittl, kittl.com, and you can see right away, yours may look different than mine, but you can see right away some of these are already using the gradient feature, so I'm going to click on this one. Oh, no, that's not. That's the same one. This one is, though, definitely using it, so you can see this really cool gradient feature. Kind of looks like Chrome, like the 80s stuff. Let's see if there's some other ones here. Well, you know what? It's easier to find if you just type in Chrome. So one of the things that you can do with this, and I'm going to show you how to do it, is Chrome. So let's do Chrome. So this one's awesome right here, and so is this one. So if you want to take these, and these are savable. So if you click on here and take that pattern, you can just change the text on it. So it doesn't have to say Chrome. It will still have that same Chrome color, or this color or that color. So it's really, really cool. So you can try those out. There's a bunch of them. There's this one right here. Look at that. There's this right here. And I'm gonna show you how to make some of these just from scratch, but you could do it on so many different cool things. And I love the different fonts that they have too that match, right? So some of these things would look really cool with some Chrome on it, right? So let's do one. I'm just going to do something really simple. I'm going to do a new project right here. We'll do my POD presets and 4500 by 5400, sure, and create. First thing we're going to do is color the background black, because we want this on a black t-shirt, right? The Chrome will look really good on that anyway. Then we need text, so let's hit T right there. You can't see it because it's default to black. I'm going to make it white. There you go. And we want to pick, Chrome can work on anything, but we want to pick a thick font. I'm probably going to use all caps, so I'm going to type this in. Let's do the word 80s, like that. We want something a little thicker, and I've been using this one, Mikodocs. Bungie would work. There's some other cool ones that are fatter on here too, so go find one that you like. I'm gonna just use this one for now. It has that like retro feel, right? Cool. The next thing we want to do is we can just hit the color. So now when we hit color, you'll see that it says solid color or gradient color. So let's play around with some gradient colors. You can see you can pick one side and the other. So instead of black, maybe we want blue here. And that already is really a really cool effect, right? But the way that they make the chrome thing is by adding more and more colors in here. So you can do that. Let's do this. Click on here and watch how I do here. You just click on there, and there's always a white in here to kind of separate it. But you also need a dark one to go right against the white. So let's do that. Let's do another one right here, but let's make this dark. And we can do the blue again, like this. And as long as we bump it up right there, I think that would be cool. And then, you know, we can change this color to maybe like a pink. And I'm gonna add another color in here just to stretch it out just a little bit, right? So we can like kind of play with these colors here. And I mean, that's not the best chrome, but you get the idea. What we're doing is we're just moving the colors over and over again to kind of get that effect, right, of the chrome. So play with it how you want, change these colors the way you want. You know, maybe it's a pink like this or something. It doesn't have to be pink. It can be different colors and so on. So some of those Chrome settings that you saw before I think would work really great. But let's play with this right now. We're gonna put a border on it. So I'm gonna put a white border on here and make it bigger. That kind of makes it stand out too. We're gonna put an effect on here. Let's do this drop down effect of the color. And we can, this can be white as well or gray. We can't see it right now, so let's offset it here and maybe add an angle like that, right? That can work too. Maybe lighter, we could do it white or we could do it dark like that. We could also do this one. I kind of like this one with the block. You can see so that's connected. That's really cool too. That can kind of give a good effect. All right, so cool. So it also does it on objects too. So if we do like a triangle here, let's go to elements and let's do a shape. And sometimes these 80 ones have like a triangle on the back. Let's turn it. They like to do like this kind of triangle. We can set this in the back by right clicking on here and to the back. And let's color this. So this is an object now instead of text. And you can do the same thing. Gradient, color. Let's say we want red, or maybe let's stick with the blue theme and then do this in blue as well, right? And then we can put like a black in the middle, do that kind of thing. And we can do two. So let's do that and kind of stretch it out. See how we're doing that? That's kind of cool, right? And then we could also do this object shadow blur, which is kind of cool with the 80s. Let's do the blur. Oh, it's black. So let's do white or pink even. That'd be cool, right? And that look 80s already. We can, how big is this blur? Yeah, cool. You know, the other thing they do on the 80s is do another triangle, kind of like a neon triangle. So let's do that. Make it about the same size, kind of tilt it like that. And instead of just the solid color, let's do a border color with the pink. Take this out. We don't need it. Border weight, there it is. Or maybe sometimes they do like a neon yellow or something. I don't know, we're just playing around. And there, and then we can do this with the blur too. So do the white blur on it. Isn't that cool? That's really, oh, this needs to go in the back too. So let's put this in the back, send to back. Or this probably should be in the back even further. Let's try that. Yeah, and we can bend this, whatever, right? Okay, so really quickly, another thing that they do on 80s is they have like a script font. So let's find a script font. We'll do T again, like this. Oh, not T, text again. We can use any of these. And there's some script fonts right here that we could use, which is really cool. We can show all. Now these are some fun script ones. I'm just gonna pick one here. I'm gonna do T just on my keyboard, T, make this white so we can see it. And let's do this fair prosper. I like that one. Yeah, so this is kind of the 80s look. I'm just gonna say this is my, yeah, 80s, oops. This is my 80s, and kind of do that. So it was big in the 80s, they did the cursive text on top of, or kind of touching the chrome, right? And then let's do costume. Since it's Halloween, this is my 80s costume. Pretty cool. Nice, right? One more thing that you could do, and I'm gonna do here, is let's go look for some like shiny things. One thing that they like to do on the Chrome in the 80s is like to put some starbursts and shiny things on here. So let's go here and do star, boom. This one's perfect. We can use any one of these. This one would work too, but I'm gonna go for this one. I'm just gonna make it white. Kind of do that like on the edge. You see how that kind of makes it sparkle? I'm gonna do another one right here. Boom. Yeah, and we could do it anywhere just to let you see that you can do this with anyone. I'm gonna do this one too. And make this white. Again, that easy. If you wanna turn it, you can. Maybe copy and put one there. Or maybe right there. What do you think of that? So there you go. This is my 80s costume. Of course, you can put more and more stuff on here. Maybe more stars around here or lines, or just give it that retro look. This is a very simple one. You can see did it in a few minutes. Got that neon look here with the blur. We did the chrome here. And again, if you want to save this, like this is already as one of the colors, which is really cool. So if you had another text, let's say we did text here. And let's make that white for now so you can see it. Can grab it. Let's say I want to try out a different one to see what it looks like. So here's Bungie, and I can just pick that color. Boom. It's already set in here. I don't have to try and color it again. It's one of the colors in the document, which is really neat, right? So I can try that. And of course, it doesn't look as good because I didn't put the white. But once we put this white border, look at that. Pretty cool, right? So try it out. Try out if you don't know what colors to pick right away, go back and go pick those chrome ones, and then you can save it and use it for different ones on your stuff. So have fun with this. I think this is a really, really good addition to Kittl. It's just gonna make things even better. You can see you can make gradients, and you don't have to make chrome gradients. You saw it in the beginning that it just with the color gradient by itself, just with regular colors, two colors is really cool too. So love this addition here, but this having it so you can add more and more colors is really cool because you can make this chrome feature and other features, I'm sure. So I'll save this design here so that you can use it, use these colors if you want, add more things to it, and you know, have fun with it. So there you go. Hopefully this tutorial is really helpful for you so that you can see the power of using those gradients on Kittl. Now, if you want to see another video that I did with Kittl, I'll put this one right here. This one I did a tarot card on Kittl, and I think that turned out really good too. So if you want to watch those, I also have a full playlist of Kittl designs, so you can watch those as well. Thanks again for watching, and as always, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.